Alright, call I am La, Yahweh by Shem Yahshua by Shem Rakakadash, double honors to the apostles and to the elders of Great Millstone. May much peace, love, and salutation to all the brothers that's doing his work in truth and sincerity. Shalom. This the brother Batak back at you again through the Spirit and power of Yahweh by Shem Yahshua with another quick lesson. This lesson is gonna be concerning Esau trying to act like he's the Egyptians in his movies, in his media, which, you know, they get all of their philosophies and all their ways of life from Egypt, the old ancient Egypt, because today is modern Egypt. You know, the word Egypt means bondage, you know, or slavery. And right now, the nation of Israel is in slavery up under the Edomites, the modern day Egyptians. So they want, these Edomites, they want to be Egyptians so bad. But, you know, when you look at Hollywood, they always painting themselves as, you know, every nationality except the Edomite. So I'm going to prove through, you know, the landmass of Africa and its conditions that the Edomites are not from Africa. They are not from Africa. This is the Hebrew name for Ham, which is one of Noah's son. His name was Ham, which, you know, Ham is known to be living, or the so-called modern-day Africans. They live right there in that region. They live in that country. They live in Africa. They're a bunch of dark-skinned, black-ass motherfuckers, man. Excuse my French. They're black. They're very dark-skinned, man. They're very dark-skinned. They're black. And one of the reasons why Esau can never be from Africa is because of the conditions of Africa. I mean, it was a time period when Esau took over Africa, you know, a region of it, you know, back during the time of the Greeks with Ptolemy. Ptolemy was, you know, he set up shop in Africa, you know, but those, you know, they not from that. That's not their natural habitat. Their natural habitat is the clefts of rocks, man. They're mountain people. They're, you know, they dwell in the rocks. This is Jeremiah chapter 49, verse 16. It says, "Thy terribleness has deceived thee in the pride of thine heart." This is speaking about the nation of Edom. "O thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rock." Right, because they're from the mountains. They're cavemen. They're cave people. They're beasts of the earth. There was looked as to be foul, or low pieces of low individuals. There was base men. It says, "That holdest the height of the hill." Right, because he's sitting at the top. He has all the money. He has all the revenue. He has all the gold, all the riches, everything his heart's desire, man. He's sitting at the top. It says, "Though thou shouldest make thy nest as high as the eagle." That's the symbol of America and many other European countries that Esau hold as a stronghold, the eagle, because the eagle flies the highest. And it's a pride thing with this devil. It says, "I will bring thee down from thence," said Yahweh. So these devils, their habitation is the cliffs of the rocks and mountains and shit, man. Look up, if you go on Google, you can look up Petra. Petra will show you a clear example, you know, of the habitation of Edom. They dwelt in caves. And those caves that are back there, they look just like a normal house here in America, because it's designed by the same people, Edomites, man. You can look up Petra. As you can see, man, it looks just like a modern day house would look in here in America. But continuing on, it says, going back to the word Ham, the name Ham means hot. Now, if you, I've never looked up the temperature in Africa. Let me type it in. What is the average temperature in Africa? Not images. Okay, it says, no, you know what? How hot does Africa? Oh. Okay, it says summer temperatures typically average around 82 degrees Fahrenheit, 28 degrees Celsius, while winter temperatures hover. I'm pretty sure Africa's way hotter than this, man. Way hotter than this. Esau probably. See, look, it says a historic heat wave in North Africa of Thursday, July 5th, brought Africa its hottest reliable measured temperature on record, 124 degrees Fahrenheit. Shit. So this right here shows you how hot Africa can get. Now let's point at one key fact about an Edomite. Sunscreen is needed in the heat. Now let's go to let's go back. Let's go to sunburn. Look at this. This is what happens to an Edomite when they're in the sun too long, man. They have no leprosy. They have no pigmentation. So how the hell you gonna be in that hot ass sun and expect your skin not to be peeling and fucking up and shit? Leprous, you're leprous, man. You have no pigmentation. The Lord stripped you of your pigmentation. I got a precept, but Edom, y'all beat our nationality out of us. You're gonna get yours beat into you, man. Salaki, my phone is freezing. Why the fuck is my phone to fucking freeze, man? This shit really picking the worst time to do this shit. I'm trying to do a lesson, my phone to fucking freeze. Ah, this is some bullshit, man. Fucking bullshit. Slack it. My phone is freezing. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30, verse 7. It says, "And Yahweh thy God will put all these curses upon thy enemies and on them that hate thee, which persecuted thee." So the Lord is going to put all of these curses on our enemies. You know, that's a fact. And one thing I want to focus on is that when the Lord caused the Edomites to beat our nationality out of us, but we're going to beat his into him, because he don't want to be an Edomite. But he got to face it. He's an Edomite. Happens when the Edomite stays in the sun too long. It says redness, your skin will turn red due to increasing blood flow. Hot skin, pain, itching or tight skin, blisters, dehydration, peeling. This is why Edomites cannot be from that landmass called Africa. You may reside there, but you're not from there, man. You think these Edomites gonna be in America, Africa? Butt naked, swinging from trees and shit? Hell no, nah, man. It's not physically possible for you devils to do, for that to be your land. That land was given, that's Ham's shit right there, man. You know? The Lord said he divided each nation his inheritance. Deuteronomy 32 and verse 8, it says, "When the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance, when he separated the sons of Adam, he set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel." Right, because the Lord is the one that gave Ham that land. That land is Ham's land. You know, that's their habitation. And I'm pretty sure Edomite ain't finna be over there in the heat with no damn sunscreen off, man. With no sunscreen on, because they're not built like that. They're not built to dwell in that land. It's not physically possible for them to be from that region. You know? It says, So I didn't want to make this lesson too long, man. I just wanted to go into this quick fact, you know, how Africa's temperature is compared to Esau's skin. You know, sound like he's going to have a lot of sunburn if he's from Africa, man. So it's not really physically possible for you Edomites to be from Africa. And this is just one way to look at it, that I was just on my spirit, man. And it's just not physically possible, man, you know. Could dwell there, but that's not really you're not Africans. You're not Africans. You know, history shows you, and they also have monuments in Africa that let you know that they're not, that so-called Edomites are not the real Africans, man. So with that, man, the Lord willing, you was edified with this quick lesson through the Spirit. I want to say, Kahalayim La, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Kakudash, double honor to my apostles, elders of Great Millstone. Peace, love, and salutations to the brothers from this work of truth and sincerity. Shalom, Kumiyash Allah, Wa Baba Kwa, Wa Bada Dwam, Shalom.